let me say, all protocol observed. Indeed, as I was introduced as the chairman of the NDC, when we had a letter of invitation, it was discussion towards the pandemic. And so we as a party, our flag bearer has already put in place a technical support team made up of experts in the health sector and disaster management and others. So we decided that two of our experts, a former chief of staff, former interior minister, Mr. Prosper Bani, who is heading the NDC COVID technical team, should be part of the team. And then Dr. Jiguapia, a former general secretary of the Ghana Medical Association, who is also a member of our team, should be here. So that, as you indicated, since it's about technical issues, when it comes to issues about technicalities, they will be able to give us the necessary technical backstopping. But I extend fraternal greetings from the former president, His Excellency John Dramani Mahama, and the entire party. And to state that when the invitation letter was brought, it was inviting 2016 flag bearer, but the NDC has gone beyond 2016. And we have a 2020 flag bearer. And so I'm representing the flag bearer and the entire party with my team. And to thank you for the opportunity and to state that we couldn't agree with you more than the pandemic has no political correlation. And for that matter, as a nation, we need to come together to put our shoulders to the wheel and to see how best all of us will assist the effort the government is putting in place to fight and defeat the pandemic, because we ought to defeat it. We should not allow ourselves to be defeated by this pandemic. And I believe that the Almighty God has blessed us with the necessary resources, human, material, and everything, to be able to work together in these very trying times to ensure that we defeat the pandemic. Your Excellency, after my statement, will present a copy of our technical team paper that they have developed to you. Already, I think one has been sent to the Minister for Information. But once we are here, we'll send you a copy. We have detailed out a number of suggestions and a number of interventions that we believe will help the effort you have already started putting in place to address the urgent challenges facing the country, not the country alone, but the global community. But before I take my seat, I want to make a few remarks. The first one is to state that our country operates a decentralized system of administration. And for that matter, you have a three-tier system made up of the central government, the regional coordinating councils, and then the metropolitan municipal and district assemblies, under which we have the various sub-district structures. Because this pandemic is virtually coming to the doorsteps of our people, we believe that a decentralized approach should be urgently adopted. We need to activate all the structures that we have. We believe that the districts have structures. As far as 1994, when I was a district chief executive, we had a district disaster plans for metropolitan, municipal, and district assemblies. And I believe that this is the time to activate those plans and those systems, the DISEX, the MUSEX, the METROSEX, and the REXEX, to work in coordination with the national security systems and national security architecture to address these issues. Your Excellency, a situation where people who are fleeing from Accra will be met at Ejisu by a municipal chief executive and be asked to come back, it's not a healthy situation. We believe that if we have structures and systems in place, the district response teams should have put in measures to curtail, contain the people. KRCC is there to support them in testing, provide them with shelter so that their movement to and from Accra back would have been averted. And that is why we are calling for a district and local mitigation approach. Your Excellency, I don't know whether the regional coordinating councils have met, but if you look at the composition of the regional coordinating councils, it is made up of two representatives of each of the regional houses of chiefs. And indeed, if you want community action, the traditional authorities have a role to play. And for that matter, my suggestion, or our suggestion, is that we need to integrate our community leaders and traditional authorities in the effort to mitigate the effect of this pandemic on our people. I also want to suggest that once we have our teachers who have left the classrooms now and are within the communities, we could also put some public education volunteer groups in place to support the effort of the national NCC. The teachers are there and they are easily accessible to the people, so that all hands will be on deck, because we've realized that public education is key in this effort at eradicating and stopping the spread of the pandemic. Your Excellency, if you visit Agogroshi Market, you will see that they are living in a different world altogether, and you wonder whether what is happening, they are aware of it. And that is only one scene where brisk activities are going on without any precaution, without any social distances, without anything. And so there is a lot of work for us to do. And that is why the role of the media is also very critical. I want to end by making a very passionate appeal to His Excellency the President that the role of the media is very critical. And in this country, we all know that we have, whether we like it or not, political divides in this country. If you go to the US now, there are a lot of people who tune in to CNN because they belong to a certain ideological persuasion. And you have a lot of people who tune in to Fox News because of the ideological persuasion. So there are people who are glued to certain media houses and who want to take public education from them. It is on this call that I'm making a passionate appeal to His Excellency the President, and to commend you for the amnesty you granted prisoners recently. Your Excellency, I'm asking for another amnesty from you. A number of radio stations have been closed down, and in our effort to ensure that we reach out to the majority of our countrymen and women, I'm appealing to Your Excellency to grant amnesty and get these radio stations that have been closed down to use their systems, their frequencies, and activate their latent frequencies and others which are not being used to reach out to the people and to reach out to them in various languages, so that we'll be able to reach out to every nook and cranny of this country for all of us to fight and bring this pandemic to a halt. I want to thank you for the opportunity and to assure you of our readiness to support your efforts in every respect that is needed. Ghana first, and we need to save ourselves. Thank you once again for the opportunity.